Lyden. Hallo? Hører du meg? Kjempebra.
Are there any English speakers in the room? You're English, so we'll keep it in English. That's okay for y'all. Because this is going to go on live stream, so it's better to have it in English. Have any of you guys tried After Effects before? Oh, everyone has. Oh, most of the people here have tried After Effects. So this is technically a beginner's course as to how After Effects works. So some stuff you've probably heard of, and then I'll be open for questions later. So first things we're going to learn, we're first going to learn about After Effects. We're going to learn about what compositions are. We're going to learn what keyframes are, what masks are, how to track, and what strokes are in After Effects. So first step, when you open up After Effects, this might seem kind of intimidating because it's just like an empty room with nothing. So the first thing we have to do is make a composition, which is technically the canvas of your scene. So you make a new composition, and usually you get width and height. And the usual width and height for full HD, that's, can anyone guess? What's full HD? Yeah, that's correct. I couldn't hear you, I'm sorry, but you said 1920, 1080, right? Yeah, that's correct, that's full HD. Oops, accident happens. So this is the full HD scene. So what we're going to start with, I'm just gonna explain quickly what keyframes are. And the first thing you have to do when you open up your composition is that you have to make a layer. And the way you do this is you press layer, press new, and you press solid. And on your solid, you can choose different colors. Usually it's black, but it could be any other color. Let's just go for black, just for a start. So this is your scene. And in your scene, you can add elements. So let's just add a circle. Oh, that's just a mask. That's one way of doing it. So that was a quick run of masks. So what we're going to start with is a video. We're going to edit a video, kind of basic visual effects. So first thing I'm going to do is show you a video. Has anyone heard of Zach King? The Vine guy, you know, he has a lot of cool videos. We don't have internet, so I can't show you, unfortunately. But I'll just show you something I created way back, and we're gonna recreate this effect in After Effects. There's no sound. So what the guy does, he jumps through the wall and comes out of the door. And this is what we're going to recreate today. So we find, now we have our composition, which is full HD, but we don't know what the size of the footage is. So what we're going to do is we're going to open up the footage in After Effects and make After Effects guess what the size is. So I'm just going to go for lecture. Yeah. No, it seemed like you were going to ask something. All right. After Effects. So this is the scene. And we're going to drag this over to this icon, which you cannot see. Oh. All right. So this icon this means new composition. And what this is going to do, it's going to create a composition that is the same size as the raw footage. So you can see this by pressing compositions and pressing composition settings. And you'll see that it's 1920 by 1080, 25 frames per second. Right? So if there are any questions, if there's something that's unclear, please feel free to ask. Right. So this scene was filmed on a tripod. in the beginning, and then when he's done jumping through the wall, I move the tripod. I'll show you. So the whole scene is actually static until I move the tripod here. And the reason for this is to lure, is to have a static footage so that it's easy to connect two footages of him jumping through the wall and then adding a shake later to kind of lure people to think that the whole scene was taken handheld, which is not. So first thing we're going to do is we're going to find the part where he jumps through. So we can start from here. We'll duplicate the scene by pressing Control D. This duplicates the layer. So we have two layers here. Right? So let's just move this. All right. So we wait until he jumps through. Okay. It's around here. And by dragging the layer like this, it initially cuts the layer. Right? So I'm going to do the same here, just to cut a bit from the beginning, because there's a lot of footage that's not necessary. So we need it from, let's start from here. So I drag this over here. Move the shots back to frame one. So we're gonna have to cut. And what we have to cut is the after scene here until here, right? So he jumps here. We already have that part, so just find here. So go back. This is the scene where I want him to jump through. So initially, we're gonna have to add some effects so that this will look believable. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna freeze frame the shot where he's about to jump through the wall. And a good tip is to use page up and page down to go frame by frame. So I think here is a good shot as to where we can cut. So what I'll do is I'll go to composition, and I'll press save frame as, and I'll call it file. Let's just put it in the G effects. Call it guy jumping through wall. Right. So now we have we've got the frame, and we're going to open this in Photoshop to cut them out. Oops. Sorry about that. Yeah, let's press the render button. So here we've got the frame from After Effects. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to cut out this guy real quick. Anyone here familiar with Photoshop? So you're kind of familiar. So most people here are familiar with Photoshop. So we're just going to use the, who's familiar with a pen tool? Great, pen tool, we're going to use it to cut the guy out. just roughly. Just being super rough here. Right. So I'm just gonna even out the white spots slightly. Doesn't have to be too accurate because the background's already white and it's gonna go pretty quickly, so just a bit of blur. That's gonna be enough. Sorry. Yeah. Super quick. Right, so we got the guy cut out, roughly. So we're gonna export this as a PNG to get the alpha. Right. So we go back to the scene, and this is on frame. You can see that down. No, all right. I'm just gonna move this a bit. On the left side, you can see the timeline, and you can see which frame we're on. So now we're in frame 90, 95. So let's just remember that. So here, you right-click, and you press Import, press Files, and this is how you import files into After Effects. Here we got the PNG. And if we hide the layers, you can see that we have this one here. Got the guy. Right. So what we're going to use are keyframes to animate him kind of going into the wall. Anyone familiar with keyframes? Most people here are familiar with keyframes. That's great. That's great. So, and can someone tell me which option here we're going to use? Yeah, it's a bit unclear. You have anchor point, position, scale, rotation, and opacity. Which one do you think we're going to use? Sorry? Position, correct. That is absolutely correct. So let's go to frame 95. Go to, we press the position. So this is a stopwatch. I don't know if you guys can see this. So the moment you press this one, and you move in the timeline, and you move something, this is going to happen. You're going to get motion here. So I'm just going to go quickly through the keyframes so you understand how they work. So this is pretty much like the static keyframes. You also have, if you mark both the keyframes, and you right-click, and you click keyframe assist, you have something called Easy Ease. Just gonna single out the layer very quickly. And what this does, it smoothens the animation so that it has a slight slower ending at the end. And if you mark both the keyframes and you right click, and you've marked them both, and you go here on the graph, you'll see that the graph slightly goes down. And this is what shows why it goes slowly at the end. And you can actually change and modify this as you like by using the pen tool and changing. So this gave a different effect. So let's just go back to our scene. Let's remove the graph. This is the graph button, by the way, so you can control this. And this is, if you press this button, it singles out the layer. So let's go back to keyframe 95. Just remove this keyframe here. And I want him to kind of disappear into the wall, right? So let's take 5 frames. I move him, let's say, about here. Right. And we're going to make him disappear into the wall. And the way to do this, is by creating a new composition with the PNG we've made. And the reason for this is so that we can add a mask on it and make him disappear into the wall. So what you do to create a new composition with a single layer is you press layer, press new, and you add a null object. A null object is an object that doesn't have any visual cue. It's an object that you can move around and connect it to other objects. So I'll just give you an example before I go over to the next stage. Is if you press this button, do you see the spiral? If you press this spiral and you drag it over to the null, it becomes the child of the null. So that means when you move the null, the other objects move and follow the null. Yes. All right. And the reason why I put the null here is just to have an empty object that does not have visual cue, just to make the composition. So you mark both the layers and you press Control Shift C, and this pre-comps the layer. So I'll call it guy jumping for wall. Right, so he's moving in this direction. Right, so let's just go back and let's create a mask. And the way you create a mask is by choosing the pen tool, and you create something that's going to just show part. Not today. All right, this is why this was confusing. All right, so this only shows the hand, because that's what I marked. But if I take the mask, and I invert the mask, it's going to show, it's going to remove the hand. So let me just remove this part, just hide this layer just for a second. Go back to frame 95. So he disappears on frame 97, actually. So what we're going to have to do is make him disappear slightly earlier. So from 95. Yeah, so we go, we move the layer on top so that he technically disappears. Right. So we're going to use this layer as a substitute. And let's just take the mask, move it away. So he's moving this way. Take the mask. So the mask was too big. So what we'll do is we'll also animate the mask. So we got the mask path here. We've made a keyframe, like usual. And this is the ending frame where he disappears. This is the effect we want. And we move him back here. Then you just press, if you press mask here, you can move the whole mask like this. So this is what we're gonna do. Just a quick test, just to see what happens, right? And let's hide the mask so you can see, right? So this was a super rough way. Okay, this is how he's going to disappear into the scene. And we have to make this more believable, right? So what we're going to do is we're going to add a mask feather. And the feather, it blurs the contour of the mask. So let's just increase this. So when you go closer, this gives a blurry effect. So let's just hide the mask for a second. And he disappears into the wall. This was very rough, so we'll have to refurnish it slightly. So I'm just going to move over to the next part, which is the tracking part, and then later we'll refurnish the character moving into the wall, just so that you can get an idea as to what it's going to look like. So let's add a track. So I have a new video file that I import. Let's make a new composition. This is just a painting, but I'm shaking the camera, right? And I'm gonna export the shaking of this camera and include it into the other shot. And the way to do this is by using an external program called Mocha, which is connected with After Effects. So we press the footage, we press animation, and we press track in Mocha. Is anyone familiar with tracking? No? All right, so let's track. Right. So the way Mocha works, it works with textures. So the more texture you have in the scene, it's easier for it to track. So I'll use a pen tool here. And let's mark somewhere that stays pretty center in the scene so that it doesn't cut and doesn't have issues with tracking. So I'd say her face is good enough cue. Right? Let's go back to frame one. And we press this one, which is track forward. Didn't work out. See? So it's tracking her face. Did, at least for a second. Here. So I'm just going to let it track. So the other shot we have is pretty long, so it's good to have a long track and data, just in case. So this tracks the position, the rotation, and also the scale. Has to track. And I can take questions while this is tracking. Any questions? You have a question? No? No question. All right. All right. So now we're going to export the tracking data. And we're going to copy to clipboard, right? This is like Control-C on the computer. If we go back to After Effects, and this is our scene, right, technically, our rough scene. And what we're going to do now, very quickly, is we're going to mark the whole scene, and we're going to press Control-Shift-C to pre-compose the scene. So we pre-compose the scene, we call it final scene. And we're going to add a null object. Why is it, why am I going to add a null object now? Any idea? You know? No? Oh, okay. All right, so the null object is there to paste the tracking data. So I just control V. You'll see there are like tons and tons and tons of keyframes. All All right, so I'm just going to move this to frame one and paste. Sometimes you might get some errors with Mocha that it tracks the anchor point instead of the position. As you can see, I'm just going to show you. Here is the null object and here's the anchor point. So what to do to solve this is you can either untag the anchor point and work. So just copy the data from the anchor point, remove it from position, move the anchor point, and let's just move this one to center. Right. So here, as you can see, the null object is moving, right? But we want to connect this with the shot we've done, right? So the way to do it is to parent your final scene to the null object. Right. And this is what we get. We get a shake, but you get a lot of black on the side, and you have to fix it. Right. The way to do this is by zooming in. It's very simple. You go in your final scene, go press transport, and you scale the shot. Right. So now the scene has tracking data, and it looks handheld. We're going to go back in our scene to fix the remaining things we have to make it look real. So first off, we have to remove the this guy. So let's go to frame 95. We'll just drag this over here. See, that was a very rough. But I kind of feel that he doesn't have enough punch. You know, it's kind of slow into the wall. So what we're going to do is we're going to make the path have a nice animation. And this is a tool I love using. Instead, if you don't have time to work with graphs, this is a perfect tool. So this tool is called Ease and Wiz. And this eases in and out, like the Easy In. But you have different options. So Expo is the most extreme one, which has like the slowest in the beginning and the fastest in the middle and slowest at the end. So we'll just press Expo, and we'll press something called Curvius because we're using mask. So we apply it. Let's see how the animation changes. It's slightly faster, slightly. But let's do this with the guy inside too, because you know the animation inside is a bit slow also. So let's go to the jumping guy here. So transform. And we apply the expo. Go back to our scene. And you know that kind of messed up on the guy, unfortunately. So let's have a slower, less dramatic in and out for this guy. So we're going back into the scene, and let's go for quad, for example. Let's just look at the animation, and that's a bit quick, right? So something to. We're going to add a blur effect on the guy so it feels a bit more believable. And the way to do this is by pressing to, you have to enable the motion blur into your scene. And you press this, and you enable it on the layer. So what happens is that you get a blur effect. And it's connected to your camera's blur settings, the shutter speed. So whoop, you get a blur effect. But you know, it doesn't really feel that good. So let's just put this here. Go back to the final scene. Let's just go frame by frame. So there's a little pause here that kind of like ruins
the shot.
So that means there's too much is in the beginning. So we have to go back, unfortunately, we have to go back to this guy. And let's just take the E's on out, just to see what happens. All right. Yeah, so this gives a... So let's just... Let's work a bit with the mask. So if we move the mask path slightly here. All right, so we got him jumping through the wall. Seems a bit crazy though. Sorry, I get, you know, have to watch this over and over again to get the right effect. All right, so let's go back to our tracked scene just to see what it looks like. Look, I'm open for suggestions as to what to do with the guy. So if you guys got any suggestions as to what I can alter. Oh, no, you seemed like you had something. Nope. All right. All right. So he's jumping through the wall, but there's still things that aren't right in the scene that we have to fix, to make it more believable. So in the scene when he jumps in, let's just go through, just to see what happens. When he jumps in and we change scene, things in the scene like lighting and if you see carefully here, this part kind of like jumps. So you got to click here, and you might have a slight smear here and some color changes on top. So we'll go back to the scene just to see what's up. Yeah. So on top, you'll notice that there's something changing. See? Dick, dick. So we have to change this so that it makes more sense. Right? So these are the scenes where we have an issue. So we're going to duplicate the layer again, the scene again. And let's duplicate this. Let's just move over to somewhere where you see that there's no issue. So we'll just use the mask again to mask the scene, okay. Let's just mask this part too. Just add a small feather to it, just in case. But we still have like a scene problem here. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna gradually change the color changes by using opacity. So here we have opacity translates, it basically means transparent. So put this here to 0, and we're gonna gradually fade in to the next scene. Right? So it's fixed here slightly, but I noticed that there's some parts under, if you see, under here, there are some issues. So let's just move this a bit. And there was also an issue with this one. So I'm just going to check if he enters. Yeah, it's clear. So now we have also the window changing colors. It gets slightly darker when he comes in. So we use the same technique one more time. Duplicate the scene. And just mark the window. Okay, let's see what happens. Alright. Now you see we have less of a color issue with the window, but we have an issue with the wall. Right? So let's just move this here. Right? But we're still having some problems with the string. So let's find somewhere in the scene where the string is relatively still. So we're going to duplicate one more layer, and we're going to remove the masks, just delete them, so that we get to make a new mask. So let's just mark this one and add a small feather in case of color changes. Going to remove the opacity to 100, and now we have the issue with him popping up in the scene. So we have to find somewhere where this is normal. All right. Still issues with this, so we're just gonna make another opacity like last time. So we don't have to worry about this until he jumps through. So here, let's take, or even better, let's do something different, because this is kind of annoying with the wind. So we can stop the string. So the way we're going to do this is we're going to use time remapping. So time remapping, you can change the time by using keyframes. So if I want this to go faster, for example, I can just move it here and move these keyframes together, and this scene will become faster, right? But what we're going to do is we're going to cut this out. We're going to go one frame ahead here, for example, and we're just going to move this all the way to the end. So it's gonna be stuck on that part. The reason why we're hiding all these things is so that we don't get an issue with, so that people don't realize that it's actually two scenes cutting together. And we have some issues behind there too, but we're just gonna look what it looks like on the final shot, the final scene, just to see if there's. And I noticed that the guy is an issue here. So let's just use the opacity again. So. Yeah, 4 minutes. All right, I got 4 minutes to wrap this up. So as you can see, he's going through, it's all good, because I put an opacity here. So while he's walking, this gradually goes over to the other scene. Yeah. All right. So let's just go to the final footage. Yeah, we can work better with the animations of him crossing through the wall. But since we only have 4 minutes, we won't be able to finish him, you know, really jumping through the wall correctly. But I'm just gonna go have, since we only have 4 minutes, I'm just gonna have some questions. Anyone questions? You got a question? Just smiling. All right. So we got 4 minutes, and I promise I was going to teach you guys something else, which is strokes. Does anyone use strokes in After Effects? You've used strokes. All right, so I'm just going to do this quickly. This is completely different from anything else. So I've just created a new scene. I'm going to import the TG logo. All right. So this is a vector file, and we're just going to scale this up. And the cool thing with vector files is that if you press this button, the thing that looks like a flower, you can scale up and never lose the information. That's the benefit of vector files. So quickly, what we're going to do is we're going to use something called strokes. And what strokes does, it draws your logo, for example. So let's go stroke. This is the effect and preset. So you put stroke on the logo. And you draw, you use the pen tool, draw. So you can either draw like this, then you make a new mask. So you make new mask by pressing this and pressing here. So now I have two masks here. So I'm just going to finish the G real quick. Oh, running out of time. Right. So what we're going to do is we're going to reveal the logo. So reveal original image. And we're going to increase the brush size. We're going to go in effects. And you have something called start and end. Right. So here we have paths. That's path one. But we want to move. We want to open up all the paths. So this is what we do. You press all masks, and what this does. Oops, sorry. We're missing one mask. All right. So let's just increase the brush size. So we got the correct logo. I'm just going to do the G now, because that's what got painted correctly. I'm just going to delete the rest. All right. So we got the end. Move it correctly. All right. And you can adjust the brush size so that gets more accurately. So, yeah, this is super slow. So let's just use the ease and whiz. Have a nice animation here. So this was super rough, but since I only have 2 minutes left, that's what I can show you. But technically, this technique is used a lot in motion graphics to reveal logos. All right, unfortunately, I have to end the show. So I hope you've learned something. I'll be sitting at the video thing. I'm the mentor. So if you have any questions in After Effects, feel free to ask me. You'll get a badge if you ask me. Some kind of thing TG has. Yeah, what? Yeah, so the next... the next lecture is cosplay. And then I'm going to have another lecture at 4 o'clock, which is about 360 production, which is, like you've seen on Facebook, there's a new format where you can film 360. I'm going to talk about how you can edit in 360 and create 360 scenes. So I hope to see you there at 4 o'clock. And thanks for me. Yeah.